Well, this is fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
How long do you think your hair is, hon?
I don't know. It's pretty long.
I mean, it is at least 2 inches.
I got clippers downstairs waiting to
That's what she said. But oh, I love that.
Got clippers downstairs waiting to... What are we doing?
It's making sure that
it looks great.
Is good.
It's perfect.
Yeah. So this afternoon, we're going to do a bit of the old chop.
I hope.
I'm nervous, though, because I think you're just going to hate anything.
I just want a light trim.
I can imagine you're quite picky.
Well, I mean, I just want a light trim.
But you've got, like, a shaver, so kind of just shave it all off.
Oh, God. I'm going to appreciate the hair while I have it. After this quarantine, I might be bald. Not because of the clippers.
Because of me stressing you out.
Me and two cats. I mean, you and two cats. House full of women.
Hey, my name's Cammie. This is Manfriend. And this episode is all about that time of the month.
I don't have that time of the month.
No, it's all the time for you. PMX, all right? When it comes down to it, I know this is a wonderful topic with your, breakfast, but PMS... Me and you have had many, many an argument, and the second you find out that it is close to that time, like the day before, you really fire me up because you'll turn around and you'll say, oh, now I understand.
Well, I feel you're very... very much misrepresenting the story. As far as we've been together now over 3 years,
mm-hmm.
and started noticing a trend early on.
And what was the trend?
The trend was that whenever it was that time, actually right before that time, not so much during that time, but right before, and it took us a while to realize this, but right before that time, imagine... What best thing I can think is, and I've never had a life experience to say this, but imagine like the biggest hurricane or like maybe the movie Twister, where before when the storm's about, well, when it's starting to hit you, you start getting the outside, and that's where the cows and stuff start flying around, that's where everything just gets decimated and just torn up, and anything in its path is killed. That's what happens. But then, during the actual time, it's like the eye of the storm. You look up, it's peaceful, it's normal. And then there's a little bit of backlash. You can't, maybe the back end is smaller. But then, and then if you survive it, just know that you got at least 20 more days. And enjoy your life then, because when it comes back, you're done.
Okay, so...
And so therefore, I know, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I'm going to...
Well, you're very long with your explanation.
Well, it's okay. This thing doesn't have to be 15 minutes or 10 minutes. If it's a good story, then it can go on. It's quarantine. People need things to do.
Yeah, so, but my attention span.
Well, that's your attention span. Other people might enjoy it. You might not. But I'm going to at least explain my side. So now, yes, I do the stereotypical, it's getting close. So that means it's going to happen. That's what's causing this. But there's a history behind it. She wants to kill me before it starts happening.
Okay. First of all, I will admit that the day before, and we both realized that it's bad. And I'm not joking. I'm not siding with him. I actually agree with him. But... you have used that as a crutch and have used that to your advantage. It means like every time you screw, now I get it.
Well, it's like...
Or we'll be in the middle of an argument and it'll be, is something close? And I'm like, you want to see me go 0 to 100?
It gives some explanation, is all I can
say.
No,
but it doesn't.
It doesn't excuse the whole...
Look within yourself.
Oh, my God.
Why can't you look within yourself and be like, what am I contributing?
Her crutch can be another episode, but she has crutches as well. Oh, it's your anxiety. Yeah. Oh, it's your depression. No, you're just annoying at times.
Yeah.
Or no, it is about to be that time, and the wrath of Cammy is coming down on Manfred and gonna kill him.
And I don't really get angry with anybody else except for you.
I have to, I mean, sometimes I sneak into my truck in the garage. And I'm glad I got a new truck because now there's a bigger back seat. And I could just kind of curl up in the fetal position. And I could just be like, please don't let her find me.
That's an exaggeration. But when it comes down to it, you cannot use it as a crutch for everything.
That's true.
You know?
It's just...
It's you are agreeing with me? You liar! It just You're going to turn around in 2 days.
It gives some explanation, is all I'm going to say. I'm not saying it explains 100%, but yeah. When you add that, it puts at least 25% of the puzzle in there.
Yeah, it sure does. What is your question for me?
I don't know, because I don't know the subjects before, which I like that. But
wow, thanks for the beer burp in my face.
We're going crazy here.
Absolutely revolting.
Crazy. My question is,
I think what I can still smell.
What do you hate the most about me in that 48 to 72 hour period prior?
Why do I hate you? The way you breathe. Holy mother of God, you have the loudest breath I've ever heard.
She's like, why are you breathing so deep? And I'm like, because I've gotten fat, Cammy, and I'm not as healthy.
But you do. You breathe like you're in outer space.
I don't know I'm doing it, but apparently my breath does.
It is so loud, and it's like, I feel like I'm gonna hear that, Cammy. I've made it to the moon. Like that's how loud you are.
Yeah, those TikTok videos I sent you with the Trey. I forget the guy's name. I send some fun ones out with Trey somebody.
Yeah.
But either way, they had one where it was couples in quarantine, and it was hilarious because they do talk about breathing. It's funny as heck.
But I'm like, how does that not make you nuts? How does that not hurt your brain? That deep breathing.
Got it. Fuel, it's a big brain. You got to fuel it with a lot of oxygen. It's got to fuel it to power everything so I can solve the problem.
You do not have a big brain.
I have a very big brain.
You have a lot.
Read with that what you must.
You do. Oh my God, you're so gross. That's been another episode of Man Friend.